So let's talk about art under Napoleon, and we're going to start with David. Now, David had gone to prison, but recovered his career when in 1804, Napoleon appointed him first painter of the empire. Now, Napoleon embraces this link with the classical past that David could give him, and this sense of authority that it brought. Now, if David can connect Napoleon to the classical past, that basically tells the people, the viewers of David's work, that Napoleon is, well, really the new embodiment of a Roman emperor. And obviously, that's the sort of thing that Napoleon wants people to think. So, with that in mind, we're looking at the coronation of Napoleon. And by the way, just to pause for a moment, look at the size of that canvas. There's someone standing directly in front of it. That is a massive, massive canvas. You do not paint this for someone who is known for their humble, their sense of humility or their sense of modesty. Now, the painting itself, the coronation of Napoleon, documents the pomp and pageantry of Napoleon's coronation. And it generally adheres to historical fact. Now, to start out, note the Pope. The Pope is sitting there in the background while Napoleon is crowning Josephine. Here's Napoleon, here's Josephine. So Napoleon is crowning Josephine. The Pope is basically a visitor and nothing else. Notre Dame is dutifully depicted as it would have been for the coronation. And we see Napoleon again crowning Josephine. So taking this act that should have been the Pope's act and taking that power from him. This is all a power play showing that Napoleon is the most powerful person in the room, not the Pope. Once again, what we see is a sense of a theatrical stage setting, which is very common in neoclassical art. So this becomes as much visual documentation as it becomes propaganda. Napoleon, the Pope, and everyone up on stage in front of the rest of the nobles of the French court, or the French court as it is. I mean, we're dealing with an empire now, but it's basically a French court. Now, this, interestingly, will speak to the separation of church and government in France under Napoleon, with the clergy off to the right, while everyone else, secular society, is off to the left. So we see the imperial court here, the clergy off separated from everyone else, and we see the light shining predominantly on the Pope, Napoleon, Josephine, and her courtesans. So the entire thing is, first of all, separating church and state. Secondly, showing us the power of the people involved. For example, this stage tells us who's in power, and based on who's standing, that's Napoleon. The rest of these people are either depicted shorter than Napoleon or depicted seated. So the whole thing is propagandistic. It's supposed to get across a specific message. In this case, Napoleon is in charge, not the church. And why is this important? Because the church had been in charge for so long in France. It's also showing Napoleon as above the rest of the people. So that's going to be important. He is the emperor, after all. So the whole thing is not only historical documentation, but visual propaganda.